السلام علیکم ناظرین، لائیو انٹریکٹیو فون ان پروگرام ٹیلی کلاس روم کے تازہ شمارے میں آپ کا خیر مقدم۔ میں ہوں آپ کا میزبان جمشید رسول،
اور میں حیا۔ ویری گڈ مارننگ ٹو آل آف یو،
ویری گڈ مارننگ ٹو آل آف یو آؤٹ دیر۔ اینڈ فار ٹوڈیز پروگرام وی ہیو چوزن دا سبجیکٹ ایز انگلش لینگویج، اینڈ نو پرائزز فار گیسنگ واٹ دا ٹاپک از۔ دا ٹاپک از، یس، اٹس اگین مائی فیوریٹ ون، فونیٹک سمبلز اینڈ پروننسیشن ان انگلش لینگویج۔ آئی ہوپ ٹو پروناؤنس اٹ کریکٹلی۔
And friends, as we all know, that English is a global language. It is widely spoken and understood all over the world. It is also the most common foreign language. This means two people coming from different regions usually speak English as a common medium to communicate.
Exactly, and this is indeed the most important language, the language of religion, the language of science, the language of international diplomacy, and the language of all those important subjects. And dear friends, on this very important topic and subject, we are proud to host in today's program Ghulam Hassan War sir, who is the research officer in State Institute of Education Kashmir. Sir, again a very warm welcome to you in today's program.
Thank you.
Then for the subject expert, again we are proud to host in today's program Dr. Taslim Ahmed War, who is assistant professor in the prestigious University of Kashmir. Sir, again, a very warm welcome to you in today's program. And you will be in the line of fire later on when the viewers would be posing all those trivial and non-trivial questions in our program. Be ready for that. And indeed, dear friends, hiya.
Yeah. And besides, we have got some special guests in our program, our students. A very good morning to all of you as well.
Yes, a very good morning to all of them. And we have the phone numbers through which you can connect us after the lecture ends. Yes, and the phone numbers are 2481813. I repeat, 2481813, and the other one is 2481832. But do not forget to prefix 0194 in case you're calling from your cell phones or in case you're calling from outside the jurisdiction of District Srinagar. And you can also connect to us through the medium of emails. Yes, we have a live email, a live feed of emails rather, and you can mail us at DDK Teleclassroom. It's quite easy to remember, DDK Teleclassroom@gmail.com. you would be sending us the emails and we would be reading them out right during the live telecast of DDK Teleclassroom. And I know for sure that all of you must be impatiently waiting for the lecture to start, but before that, a short break. خیر مقدم، ایک بار آپ کا پھر سے لائیو ڈی ڈی کے ٹیلی کلاس روم میں ہمارے ساتھ بنے رہنے کے لیے آپ کا بہت بہت شکریہ۔ یہ بتاتا چلوں ناظرین کہ یہ پروگرام آپ تک ڈی ڈی کے سری نگر، دوردرشن کیندر سری نگر اور ڈائریکٹوریٹ آف اسکول ایجوکیشن کے باہمی اشتراک سے پہنچایا جاتا ہے۔ اس کے علاوہ ایک اور انفارمیشن یہ کہ دیر ہیز بین اے ری شیڈولنگ آف دا نیکسٹ سنڈیز لائیو ڈی ڈی کے ٹیلی کلاس روم۔ دا ٹائمنگ ہیز بین ری شیڈولڈ، ناؤ اٹ وڈ بی ٹیلی کاسٹ لائیو فرام 10 AM ٹو 11 AM اینڈ only on that Sunday. Please be remindful of that particular fact, that only on the next Sunday we are rescheduling the timing from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Then as far as the repeat telecast of this very program is concerned, it would be telecast repeat on Tuesday evening at from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. Then again on Thursday morning we would be telecasting the repeat telecast of this very program from 9:10 a.m. to 10:10 a.m. So all of you must be impatiently waiting for the lecture to start. The stage is all yours, Ghulam Hassan War sir. Have a great one.
Thank you, sir. Hello, good morning to all of you.
Good morning, sir.
I am GH War, and today once again I am going to discuss, I think it is for the first time that I am going to discuss about phonetic symbols, pronunciation in English. Why this topic has been chosen? Because this is greatly needed in day-to-day English that generally people speak. And what I have observed so far, because I'm a teacher teaching at different levels, what I've seen, it is not only that the teachers or the students commonly misspelt or mispronounce some of the words, but mostly other professionals also. So today I would like to give you the drill of those words that are commonly wrongly pronounced by our teachers and by the students as well. For that, I've got the opportunity to be with you, and let me directly come to the topic, and the topic is pronunciation in English. But before going to that, let me write a sentence here. I'll begin it like that. I'll write a sentence and you'll read it. For example, now my students, two words, I'll highlight these two words, underline these two words, who will speak this sentence, who will read this sentence. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
I wonder why they wander.
Okay. One more.
Sir. I wonder why they wander.
Okay. See what happens. When we speak a word wrongly in a sentence, you know what happens? The meaning of a sentence changes. I'll even try to write the phonetic transcription of some words so that you can feel that how important this pronunciation is. Because we want to say something, whereas we mean something else. Because we, no doubt we are not foreigners, but at least we must try to speak English correctly. So, the word this, if you speak this word wrongly, wander, that has some different meaning. The word is wander. This is wander, and this is wander. See the difference? If I say, I wander, so it means that I have to say, I'm surprised why they are walking here and there without any reason. But what I say, I walk here and there, and why they are surprised. So the meaning changes. The second sentence. I've underlined a word here. Please read this sentence.
If, full sentence?
No, I mean to say full sentence.
There was a big row while gas collection.
Now see, what I mean to say, this word R-O-W, it has two pronunciations and it has two meanings. Mm. But the meaning is totally different to what I mean to say. For example, I mean to say dispute.
Yes.
That is row. There was a big row while gas collection. It is not row. Row means line, and row means
dispute.
See, when we say a word wrongly, automatically the meaning of that sentence changes. And it not only affects the meaning of a sentence, but grammar as well. Let me write one more sentence. For example, I can write here, you have to write an article, a or an. Like this. Because this is the beginning. Word is E-W-E. Can you read the word?
Ew.
If you say ew, it is incorrect. The word is you, as in Y-O-U. So if you say ew, it means that you have to put an before it. But it directly affects the grammar part. So, a you. So it is like this. This is its correct pronunciation. You. It is not you. One more part. I'll write here, when we are talking about homophones in English, let me write three words, F-L-O-U-R, F-L-O-W-E-R, and F-L-O-O-R. If I ask you to choose two words that are homophones from this group. Homophones means those words in English that have different spellings but same pronunciation. Can you give me the and different meaning? Can you give me two words from this group which are homophones?
Floor and floor.
Which one?
F-L-O-U-R and F-L-O-O-R.
This. And this is incorrect. That's why I say this. So, most of the students say like this. They say floor and flow. But this is pronounced as F-L-O-W-E-R. So the word is flower, the word is flower, and it is flow. That's why I have chosen this topic today, to be very conscious while using these terms, these words, not only in sentences, but also in grammar as well. So it is not only the students, but what I have observed, doctors or different lawyers, professionals, they use it wrongly. Even in banks, I'll write some simple words for you. Please read this word, R-E-C-E-I-P-T.
No, it's receipt.
The word is correct pronunciation is a receipt, not as a recept, as mostly the people say. That's incorrect. So that's why this topic has been chosen for you, so that we may try to be correct in speaking and what and clear in meaning. Now, I'll give you the drill of words first, where we find that generally why, where these people, mostly common people, commonly mispronounce these words. For example, the word is, I don't want to write there because I have to go a long way off. Here is the word, S-U-I-T-E. How can you pronounce the word?
Sweet.
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 But it is not suit, it is sweet, as in S-W-E-E-T. So these are homophones. And this has one meaning, this has another meaning. A well-furnished room having attached sofas and a bathroom. That is sweet. The word is?
Sweet.
Not as suit. Okay, E-W-E, what is now this?
U.
U, very good. And F-L-O-U-R, O-W-E-R and F-L-O-R, you know this now?
Yes.
What is this?
Flower.
Flower. What is this?
Flower.
And what is this?
Flow.
Flow. Very good. W-A-T-E-R, what is this?
Water.
It is water.
Water.
The word is?
Water.
Not water. And that's, I have written here that there is another word,
water.
V-O-T-E-R. What is this?
Water.
What is the difference then? It is water and this is water.
Water.
What is this?
Water.
There is O. I am going to show you the symbols, these monophthongs and diphthongs later on in my lecture, and that's why this is water. What is this?
Water.
And this is this? What is this?
Water.
Water. What is this?
Water.
Okay. C-R-O-R-E?
Crow.
Crow. What is this?
Crow.
And then what is this?
Crow.
No, it is crow. This is crow, and this is crow. What is this?
Crow.
Very good. M-O-R-T-G-A-G, generally spoken by these lawyers.
Mortgage.
What is the word?
Mortgage.
How do you pronounce the word?
Mortgage.
Of the mortgage. You say mortgage, but it is incorrect. The word is mortgage. The word is?
Mortgage.
It is never mortgage. What is this?
Mortgage.
Mortgage. And even if, let me write, it is m-o-g-e and j. This is mortgage. Like this. Then, see the word, commonly mispronounced, P-E-O-N. How do you pronounce it?
Peon.
The word is P-E-O-N. What is this?
P-E-O-N.
British and American, it is peon. Now, C-H-A-I-R?
Chair.
Chair. What is this?
Chair.
It is not cheer, but this is chair. This is cheer, but this is chair. The word is?
Chair.
I have written here the word cheer. Ear and air. Later on, I'll go to the symbols. And here's a word generally spoken wrongly by our students that are from sinus group. The word is C-H-A-M-E-L-E-O-N.
Chameleon.
Chameleon. It is not chameleon, as most of the students say. The word is?
Chameleon.
Chameleon. Very good. W-A-L-L. What is this?
Wall.
Wall. What is this?
Wall.
Hole. Tall. All. Call. And we say call, tall, wall. Totally incorrect. Then, here is a word, A-M-O-N-G.
Among.
Among. What is the word?
Among.
Not among, but it is?
Among.
Among. About. What is this?
About.
Again. What is this?
Again.
Alone. What is this?
Alone.
Not alone, but it is?
Alone.
Very good. See the word, V-A-S-E.
Was.
The word is was. The word is
was.
And American is race. That is correct. But we neither speak, pronounce American nor British. Generally, what our listeners are, what the users of English language, they use their own pronunciation without looking to the dictionaries, which are the correct. We can no doubt use American somewhere, but we have to use the British accent, but mostly we use our own. That's neither American nor British. Now here's a word, for example, when you are going to speak and there is a stage put, and there's a word D-A-I-S.
Dace.
Generally, dace. Let him come to the dace. People say dice. That is not the dace. Correct word. Dace. What is the word?
Dace.
And spelling is D-A-I-S. Let me write it as correct pronunciation. See, this is dace. The word is?
Dace.
Not dice. So mind it. Come to the dace. Dice is something, something D-I-C-E, where people generally gamble with that kind of tool. Okay. Then, this is poem. What is this?
Poem.
C-H-A-S-M. I have chosen these words from the books 8th to 10th. So mind it. Here's a word, C-H-A-S-M. This is the term that comes in geography. Geography. Chasm. The word is?
Chasm.
So it is not necessary that C-H can give us only ch sound, but sometimes it gives us k sound as well. Then, see a word here, C-H-I-C.
Chick.
C-H. How can you pronounce the word?
Chick.
Yes?
Chick.
No, it is not chick, C-H-I-C-K, no doubt that is chick. But the word, it is a new word here. It is chic. The word is?
Chic.
So here, C-H gives us sh sound. Sh, E, K. Chic, something fashionable. Then, L-A-W and O-R-D-E-R. Generally, what we say?
Law and order.
Law and order. It is not law. It is law and order.
Law and order.
Good. Then, B-E-A-R.
Bear.
What we say?
Bear.
It is not beer, it is bear. The word is?
Bear.
There is a difference between ear and air. Then, let me. Yes, what is the word? P-A-W.
Paw.
It is not paw, it is paw. The word is?
Paw.
Not paw. M-O-U-S-T-A-C-H-E. Mustache. How do you pronounce the word?
Mustache.
No, it is incorrect. It is mustache. The word is?
Mustache.
And the American one is mustache.
Mustache.
There is no mustache as what the people say.
Acid.
Acid. The word is?
Acid.
Not acid, but it is?
Acid.
Okay. B-U-I-L-D.
Build.
Build. What is this?
Build.
Not build, but?
Build.
G-U-I-L-D.
Guild.
Guild. Not guild. What is the word?
Guild.
Guild. Very good. T-I-N-Y.
Tiny.
Tiny. Not tinny, as the people say. What is the word?
Tiny.
Small. Little. S-A-W.
Saw.
So. Not saw, but?
Saw.
So. I'll give you one more word. S-E-W.
Sue.
No, this is so. The word is?
So.
S-E-W. What is the word?
So.
So. So, then O. As in? S-O. So, as in?
No.
Then N-O follow? How
no.
Can it be?
No.
N-O?
No. No.
It is no. What?
No.
Not no, but?
No.
G-O?
Go.
Go. No. Go. So. Same is the case with S-E-W. So. B-O-S-O-M.
Bosom.
No, the word is bosom. The word is?
Bosom.
Bosom. P-R-E-S-S-E-D.
Pressed.
Pressed. What is this?
Pressed.
Pressed. Q-U-A-S-I. Anyone who can speak it correctly, I'll give him or her a notebook of worth rupees 50.
Quasi.
Q-U-A-S-I.
Quasi.
Yes?
Quasi.
The word is?
Quasi.
Anybody among you who can win this?
Quasi.
How do you pronounce?
Quasi.
No, the word is quasi.
Quasi.
The word is?
Quasi.
Quasi. I'll write the pronunciation of this word. This is quasi.
Quasi.
Okay. Please read this word.
Twilight.
Twilight. What is the word?
Twilight.
Not twilight. G-R-E-W.
Grew.
No, the word is grew. It is grew. What is the word?
Grew.
Not grew, but?
Grew.
Grew. C-R-E-W?
Grew.
Grew. Not crew. B-L-E-W?
Blue.
Blue. F-L-U?
Flu.
Flu.
F-L-E-W?
Flu. Not flu, but flu.
Flu.
What?
Flu.
Then, here's a word. M-A-R-T-Y-R.
Martyr.
Yes.
Martyr.
No, the word is martyr.
Martyr.
The word is?
Martyr.
It is not martyr. It is the word, correct pronunciation is?
Martyr.
Martyr. Then, Y-A-C-H-T.
Yacht.
No, it's not yacht, but the word is yacht.
Yacht.
The word is?
Yacht.
Yacht. And C-U-C-U-M-B-E-R.
Cucumber.
Cucumber. The word is?
Cucumber.
Not cucumber, as people say. The word, correct pronunciation is?
Cucumber.
Cucumber. Then T-O-M-B.
Tomb.
Tomb. Tomb. What is the pronunciation?
Tomb.
Tomb. C-O-U-P.
Coo.
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 It is not coop, but it is?
Coo.
Coo. The word is?
Coo.
Coo. Okay, C-O-M-B?
Comb.
Comb. The word is?
Comb.
Not comb. Like that. Huh. Doctors say D-O-S-E.
Dose.
What is the word?
Dose.
It is dose, not dose. The word is?
Dose.
D-O and sir. Dose. Okay. Then, some words are there. For example, W-O-U-N-D, it can be pronounced in two ways, wound, when it is an injury, and wound, when it is used as verb. Past form of wind.
Okay.
Then there is wind, and wind.
Hmm.
Past form of wind, that is wound, and wound, when it is injury. Here's a word, I-R-O-N.
Iron.
Yes.
Iron.
Here, R is silent, it is iron. The word is?
Iron.
Not iron, as the people say. Okay, one more. Anybody who can speak this word correctly? M-A-G-I.
Meiji.
Shabash.
Meiji.
M-A-G-I.
Meiji.
Magi? Or kuch?
Meiji.
Meiji.
No, the word is Meiji. The word is?
Meiji.
I'll write its pronunciation. M-A. J-I. The word is Meiji. Now, why I give the drill of these words? Because see, where we are, what we speak. And if we say Maggie or Maggie, some different meanings. But when we say Meiji, it has some different meaning. Okay? What is the word? I-R-K-S-O-M-E.
Irksome.
Irksome, not irksome. Good. It is irksome. W-A-S-H?
Wash.
Wash. Not wash, but?
Wash.
Washroom, not washroom. Okay. M-A-R-S.
Mars.
Mars. Mars. What is this?
Mars.
Mars. The name of that
planet.
Star. Now, A-double-S.
Ass.
Ass. Not os, but it is?
Ass.
T-O-R-T-O-S-E.
Tortoise.
It is tortoise. The word is?
Tortoise.
Not tortoise or something. The word is?
Tortoise.
Tortoise. What?
Tortoise.
Tortoise, not tortoise.
Tortoise.
Once again, I can, tortoise, what is this?
Tortoise.
Tortoise. It is this is tortoise. Not tortoise or what you say. Then, B-A-N-T.
Ant.
Ant, not aunt. A-U-N-T is aunt, but A-N-T is?
Ant.
Ant, like this. This is ant. Now, here's a word, P-O-S, no, this word first, E-X-E-R-C-I-S-E.
Exercise.
You say exercise, that's incorrect.
Exercise.
Exercise. What is the word?
Exercise.
Yes?
Exercise.
Very good. P-O-S-I-T-I-O-N.
Position.
Position. Not position, but it is?
Position.
Very good. P-O-S-T-P-O-N-E.
Postpone.
No, the word is postpone. The word is?
Postpone.
Postpone. That's... You did wrong. It is like this. Postpone. This is its correct pronunciation. Correct. This is what I write in slanting bars. That is, it is transcription. Now, here's a word.
I-N-S-T-I-T-U-T.
Institute.
Institute. What is this?
Institute.
Not institute. That's incorrect. British say that it is institute, whereas the Americans say institute. That is the difference. Not as people generally say what comes in their mouth. They say that it is whatever we wish. But that's not the case in English. Then here's a word. A-T-T-I-T-U-D.
Attitude.
Attitude. What is the word?
Attitude.
Not attitude, but the word is?
Attitude.
Attitude. Attitude. This is its phonetic symbol. Attitude. Okay. Then, here's a word. O-P-P-O-R-T-U-N-I-T-Y.
Opportunity.
Opportunity. What is the word?
Opportunity.
Not opportunity, but?
Opportunity.
What is this?
Opportunity.
Opportunity. It is opportunity. Then there is a word, R-E-L-E-A-S-E.
Release.
Release. The word is?
Release.
Not release, but?
Release.
W-O-M-E-N.
Women.
Women.
Women. The word
women.
Is?
Women.
There should be the difference, W-O-M-E-N and W-O-M-E-N. Hmm. Singular and plural. We say woman in both the cases, woman and women, no. The word is woman and women. Women and?
Women.
Here's the word, P-R-A-C-T-I-S-E-D.
Practice. Practice.
No, the word is practice it. What is this?
Practice.
Even if it is, it is a verb, practice it. What?
Practice.
Not practice it. I have practiced many words before you. So some words more. Here's the word, H-A-P-P-Y.
Happy.
Happy. Not happy, but?
Happy.
Good. C-A-U-G-S-T, C-O-U-R-T, and C-O-A-T. I'll write these three words here. C-A-U-G-S-T, C-O-U-R-T, C-O-A-T. Which two words from this group are as homophones?
Coat and coat.
Which
coat.
One? Coat. Yes?
C-O-U-R-T and C-O-A-T.
C-O-R-T.
First and?
Coat.
And that's incorrect. That's
no,
what we
second
generally
and I said second and
yeah, it is. First and
second.
Coat and coat. His coat behind. See, they never say cart behind. So we generally say cart. That's incorrect. The word is
coat.
As in
coat.
Coat. It is coat.
Coat.
It is coat. It's coat. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the word is C-A-L-C-U-L-A-T-E. What is this?
Calculate.
Calculate. So these are some of the words. Not only these words, but there are hundreds of such words that we generally speak incorrect. Mm-hmm. And the listener that listens before us, and he feels that how competent the person is who is speaking before them.
Yes,
so when you speak English, try to speak it correctly so that others can think that, yes, the person is speaking it correctly.
Yes,
now, let me come to the point. How can we overcome such problems now in English? That is the question. Question is that. Let me try to solve this kind of problem. You know in English, how many letters are there?
26.
Good. There are 26 letters in English. And these 26 letters, you know how many sounds these give us?
44.
26 letters are in English?
Yes.
First of all, can you tell me what is the difference between letters and alphabet?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So alphabet is only one. That is A to Z, we call that. That is English alphabet. But letters are 26. It's A,
that
B,
is a chart. Mostly people use it incorrectly. They say, let me write alphabet A, alphabet B. That's incorrect. Actually, those are letters.
Letters
are from alphabet group from A to Z. Okay? Mm. So this is the difference, that a set of letters, that is an alphabet.
Alphabet.
What is this?
Alphabet.
Alphabet. What is this?
Alphabet.
Good. And these 26 letters produce us 44 sounds. And there are two groups. Groups. 44 sounds. And these 44 sounds are put in two groups. One is consonants, and the second one is
vowels.
Consonant sounds and vowel sounds. Generally, you have been asked, yeah?
What's the difference between consonant sound and vowel sound?
Very good. And that is the question that I want from you. Sit down, please. And you know, a consonant sound is that when we, generally the air, generally the air comes out from our lungs, then it comes out from our throat, then through mouth. There are different parts in our mouth, tongue is there, teeth, etc., etc. When it is obstructed, when we speak, when we utter sound, when the air comes out and it is obstructed in the mouth, it is consonant sound. And when the air comes freely out of our throat, that is what I say a vowel sound. Now, please, can you give me what is this word? H-E-I-R?
Hair.
Air.
No, the word is air. The word is
air.
As in air. Let me now directly come to the symbols that we have. You know, in English.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes. Please.
What is it? What is the difference between sound and symbol?
Yeah. When we speak something, that becomes a sound. And when we write, that becomes a symbol. For example, I'll write this. This is sh in English. This is a symbol. This is a?
Symbol.
When we speak, that is a sound. That is a?
Sound.
Good. You know, in English, there are 20 vowel sounds. And these 20 vowel sounds are monophthongs and diphthongs. There are short vowel sounds. These are 7. And long vowel sounds, these are 5. Then there are diphthongs, these are 8. That means double vowel sounds. Mono means single. And let me write it here. This is I. This is
I.
Can you see this?
Sir.
This is I. And this is it is long. This is E. For example, I as in IT it, SIT sit, FIT fit.
Sir, where I have a question.
Sound? Yes.
Sir, how it is possible that letters are 26, but
sounds are 44.
44.
Very good question. And see, I'll give you one example. For example, here is A. I'll write here 88. The second sound, 88. Here it is A. And here it is A. Okay? I'll write here F-A-T-H-E-R. What is this?
Father.
So here it gives us, this A gives us R sound. If I write this G, I'll write one word, A-N-G-L-E, what is this?
Angle.
A-N-G-E-L, what is this?
Angel.
So here this G gives us G sound and here this gives us
G sound.
Good. So that's why one letter can give us more than a sound and that's why there are 44 sounds and letters are 20. And English is not a phonetic language. Because there, it is not possible that one letter can give us only one sound. Because one letter can give us more than a sound. That's why English is considered as a non-phonetic language.
Sir, one question.
Yes, please.
How can we define a vowel?
We can define a vowel freely. Just I have already, sit down, please. I have already told you that a vowel is a sound. Is a sound that comes freely out without the obstruction in air. When we speak and our air comes freely out from our mouth. That's the vowel sound. Now, these symbols are, this is E, and the long is E, as in eat, seat, feet. Then this is A, as in up, us, cut. This is A, long sound, as in art, arm, father. This is U, as in put, full, wood, wool. W-O-O-L, what is this?
Wool.
It is not wool, it is?
Wool.
And the long is oo. This is pool. Pool. This is cool. This is food. F-O-O-D. What is this?
Food.
Not food, it is?
Food.
Good. This is a, as in aside, along, father. Here it is in the beginning, and here it is at the end. This is a, as in earth, as in bird, as in pearl. As in?
Pearl.
What is the pronunciation of H-E-A-R-T-H?
Hurt.
H-E-A-R-T-H?
Hurt.
No, it is heart. It is?
Heart.
It is never a hurt. That is why I use some of the words here. Now, this is O. What is this?
O.
Not fully rounded. So, as in hot, got, shot. And this is O. As in course, force, horse. A-L-L.
All.
What is this?
All.
Very good. And this is A, as in egg, leg,
net.
This is A, as in at, mat,
cat.
Now these are the list of monophthongs, short and seven are short and five are long.
So one question, please.
Yes?
What's the difference between a vowel and a consonant?
I already told you. Sit down, Betty. Achha question hai. I already told you that a consonant sound is that where our air is hindered.
Locked.
Or obstructed in a mouth. It does not come freely. For example, we say A, C. The air comes. We say B. Both of our lips are closed, and we cannot produce a sound unless we open. That's the consonant sound. Now, diphthongs, A diphthongs are there. This is ear. What is this?
Ear.
As in E-A-R. Zara ye pidiye?
Ear.
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 Ear. This is ur. What is this?
Ur.
As in ur. Cure.
Cure.
This is air. What is this?
Air.
As in air. Where? W-H-E-R-E. What is this?
Where.
H-E-I-R.
Air.
Air. What is this?
Air.
And this is A. The sound is?
A.
As in ale. Say. Day.
Way.
Here is oil. The sound is?
Oil.
It's oil. Boy. Toy. Joy. The sound is? I. The sound is?
I.
It's the symbol. I. My. Try. Shy. This is O. What is the symbol?
O.
As in so,
so,
no,
go,
meadow. M-E-A-D-O-W. What is the word?
Meadow.
Meadow. Not meadow, but
meadow.
This is out. This is?
Out.
Out. As in out, now, cow, how. Beauty. Okay. See. This is B-E-A-U-T-Y, beauty, bur, then ye, u, te, and e. This is beauty. This is?
Beauty.
Beauty. Then ye sound is there. As in cure. For example, if you say C-U-R-E, what is the word?
Cure.
It is ke, then ye, then u, then this. This is cure. Yeah, cure. So let me now come to the consonant sounds. These are 24. Consonants are
24.
But most of the sounds resemble our English letter. Our English letter. These are 16. But 8 are different. Let me tell you what sounds are those that are different in consonant sounds. What are the symbols? For example. There is this. This is sh. This is
sh.
As in push. As in
push.
This is ch. This is
ch.
As in church. As in
church.
Good. This is the. This is
the.
As in the. It is the as well as the. When there is a vowel sound, it is then. This is th. This is
th.
As in think. As in
think.
This is ye. As in you.
You.
Or E-W-E. Then this sound. This is unk. As in ing.
Ink.
King. Think. Etc. So, I hope that you would have understood all these 44 sounds. Thank you very much for your cooperation. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
Any question?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
Excuse me, sir.
What's the pronunciation of human?
Human. You have spoken it correctly. It is human. It is not human. It is human. Her, ye, u, ma, a, and na. Human. What is the word?
Human.
Good. Yes, any more
questions? So what's the pronunciation of the word apartheid? A-P-A-R-T-H-E-I-D.
That is apartheid.
Apartheid.
Yeah. Okay. I think that you'll go through the symbols that are there shown in the books, 9th and 10th class books. Hope that you would go through these books and see the dictionaries yourself, not to go to any expert for these symbols. You can practice at home, and I hope that you can be able to speak correctly. Okay. Thank you very much.
Well, we also hope that all the misspelled words would be spelled correctly now. Thanks a lot, Varsur. Please baith jaiye aur thoda sa pani pi lijiye. And this lecture was a bit of a self-discovery for me also, because mujhe bhi aaj pata chala ki kafi aise words hain English mein jo ki main bhi galat pronounce karta hoon. Sir, thanks a lot for this wonderful lecture. Aur nazreen, ek chhoti si information bhi deta chalun ki 12th jamaat ke jo nataij hai wo aana aaj jo hai mutawakka hai, to tayari kar lijiye. Ho sakta hai aapko bhi kisi rishtedar ke yahan jana ho mithai ka dabba leke, to uski aap tayari kar lijiye. Aur अब प्रोग्राम का वो दिलचस्प मरहला जो है आ चुका है जब आप हमारे साथ जुड़ते हैं. हमारे जो टेलीफोन नंबरात है वो है 248-1832, 248-1832 और 248-1813 और 248-1832. नीचे हमारे टेलीफोन नंबरात जो है वो स्क्रॉल हो रहे हैं, तो हम आपके साथ जुड़ते हैं. लेकिन कुछ जाबते के तहत हम आपकी कॉल्स लेते हैं. जैसे कि जो भी क्वेश्चन आपको पुट फॉरवर्ड करना हो वो आप एक मिनट के स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम के दौरान करें. एंड व्हेन यू कॉल अस प्लीज कीप योर टेलीविजन सेट ऑन द म्यूट मोड, और इन केस यू डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू कीप इट ऑन द म्यूट मोड मेक श्योर दैट इट्स इनऑडिबली लो. सो विद दीज रेगुलेशंस आई थिंक इट्स टाइम टू टेक अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक, एंड ऑन द अदर साइड ऑफ द ब्रेक वी विल गेट कनेक्टेड टू यू. जी बिल्कुल नाज़रीन, एक बार फिर से हमारे साथ बने रहने के लिए आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. और हम आपके लाइव ईमेल्स ले रहे हैं @ddktelclassroom@gmail.com, और बहुत सारे ईमेल्स हमारे पास पहुंच चुके. सुहेब बट लिखते हैं कि वाई सो मच थ्रस्ट ऑन दीज प्रोनाउंसिएशंस, वाई सो मच थ्रस्ट, बिकॉज ही सेज लाइक कि जो हमारा कॉमर्स होता है, बिजनेस होता है, उसमें तो लोग अपना मदर टंग इन्फ्लुएंस लेके अंग्रेजी बोलते हैं और वो भी कामयाब लोग है. कुछ लोगों की एग्जाम्पल भी दी है. सो वाई सो मच थ्रस्ट ऑन प्रोनाउंसिएशन, सुहेब भट्ट हमें लिख रहे थे.
जी देखिए, एक चीज है, आई मीन दिस फैक्ट इज टू बी बोर्न इन माइंड नेसेसरीली
जी
दैट प्रोनाउंसिएशन इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज.
जी
आई मीन यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू साउंड अ फूल वैन यू स्पीक इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. यू शुड साउंड नेचुरल,
राइट,
एंड यू शुड साउंड एफर्टलेस एट द सेम टाइम. बेसिकली वॉट हैपन्स इज दैट वैन यू स्पीक इंग्लिश द वे नेटिव स्पीकर इज स्पीकिंग, यू आर इम्पॉर्टिंग दैट कलर टू इट. यू आई मीन इट हैज इट इज ओन डेलिकेसी. And when you speak it rightly, it looks nice. It looks natural. I mean, you won't sound a native speaker. That is there. But at the same time, what is wrong in speaking it correctly? So it's about correct speaking.
जी बिल्कुल, हमारी पहली कॉल हम तक पहुंच चुकी है. जोर अहमद साहब कॉल कर रहे हैं हमें काकापुरा से. अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में. जोर अहमद साहब, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में. अपने टेलीविजन सेट का वॉल्यूम कम कर दीजिए सर.
ये मैंने पहले वो कम करके रखा है.
जी
sir, I have some questions.
Yes, please, shoot them.
I want to know about the aspirated H. And number two, what is the pronunciation of actual situation and R-I-G-H-T-E-O-U-S?
एक बार फिर से जो आपका जो 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 दूसरा क्वेश्चन है प्रोनाउंसिएशन के बारे में वो एक बार फिर से रिपीट कर दीजिए.
I want to know the exact pronunciation of the word A-C-T-U-A-L.
जी.
And the second one is situation.
Situation, right.
And
situation,
the third one right. is R-I-G-H-T-E-O-U-S.
Right. I think the third one is, again, please repeat. R-E-I.
R-I-G-H-T-E-O-U-S.
Right. I think the three words have reached us. Thank you for calling.
One more question is.
Please go on.
How can we pronounce the words which have CH in them? Whether they are CH or whether they are CH or whether the pronunciation is CH. And fourth question is, what is the difference between how can we pronounce if put is put, why not but put?
राइट, आई थिंक पूरा एक वो कहते हैं ना एक पूरा क्वेश्चन पेपर लेके आप आए हैं. आप कुछ सवालों के जवाब सुनिए हमारे. आप जवाब दे. सहरिश हमारे साथ जुड़ चुकी है. अस्सलाम वालेकुम मैम. बैंगलोर से सहरिश जी जुड़ चुकी है हमारे साथ. अस्सलाम वालेकुम मैम, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम बेटा.
हम
बेटा अपने अपने टेलीविजन सेट का वॉल्यूम आप कम कर दीजिए.
जी आई वांट टू आस्क यू टू वर्ड सर दैट व्हाट इज द आई वांट आई एम सेलिंग फुल ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड फेस आई वांट टू आस्क question to Varsha that what is the pronunciation of dictionary?
What is the correct pronunciation of dictionary? Well, thanks a lot. आप तो पूरा basic question ही लेके आए. Thanks a lot, बेटा. Bangalore से call करने के लिए आपका बहुत-बहुत शुक्रिया. Sir, पूरे 4-5
सवाल हमारे पास हैं. Yes. So I'll try to answer almost all the questions. The, if I remember it, if I heard it rightly, the question number one was about aspiration.
Right.
It was about aspiration her.
Uh-huh.
The point is that basically it's a technical term.
Right.
You know, there are some consonant sounds mm-hmm. which are aspirated in the beginning. And unaspirated in the end.
Right.
For instance, the consonant sound p. Mm-hmm. The consonant sound p is aspirated in the beginning.
Jee.
For instance, pen. Mm-hmm. Pen.
Right.
It's pen. Uh-huh. So it is released with an extra puff of air.
Uh-huh.
And the same p becomes p. It's, I mean, there is no aspiration.
Right.
For instance, top. So there, yes, of course. So there is a difference. You see that it's pen. And that is top.
So we can say it matters where the alphabet is.
Absolutely.
Placed.
I mean, just as we as human beings behave differently in different environments,
right.
sound is also behave differently in different environments.
Right.
That is one. Second is it is actual. Without going into the details, the pronunciation is actual. In the same way, third, another question is it is situation also and situation.
Mm-hmm.
Both are correct.
Right.
And
then we had one more question. How is CH pronounced? I think that also depends on where it's placed.
Yes, it depends where it's placed. Sometimes it is ch.
For example, in chemistry.
Yes, it is. It's k there.
Right.
So in certain contexts, it is released as k, mm-hmm. and in certain contexts, it is released.
Rozmarra ke kaam kaj, daily chores hum usko.
Yes, daily chores.
Right.
So there it is ch. Another question: put and but.
Mm-hmm.
The question was why put is put and why but is but.
Right.
It depends upon actually the vowel sound which is in between them.
Mm-hmm.
In the first case, for instance, I mean put. When it comes to put, it is u sound there somewhere in between.
Jee.
And when it comes to but sound, it is a sound there.
Right.
So this is the difference between the two.
Absolutely. And besides that, sir, we are also we got one more question. How is dictionary pronounced?
Dictionary, it's pronounced in the same way. I mean, there is nothing. It's pronounced in the same way.
Dictionary.
इस खूबसूरत से और मुख्तसर से जवाब के लिए आपका शुक्रिया. अल्ताफ साहब जुड़ चुके हैं हमारे साथ बड़गाम से. अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर. अल्ताफ साहब अस्सलाम वालेकुम, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम
सर. हमें पहले मैं इस सर को ही मुबारकबाद देना चाहता हूँ कि इस तरह हमें सिखा रहे हैं सर.
जी
हमारे दो क्वेश्चन भी बैठे हुए हैं छोटे छोटे से, ये भी सीख रहे थे सर.
वंडरफुल.
पहली बात यह है सर कि हमें तो पहले इंग्लिश में इतनी महारत तो नहीं है सर.
जी
आप सुनकर बहुत खुश हुए. मुझे भी अब इंग्लिश में जाने का एक शौक पैदा हो गया सर. इसके जो ये हो रहा था अभी ये प्रोग्राम सर सुन रहे थे और ये बच्चे भी देख रहे थे सर.
जी
तो इसके लिए मैं पहली गुजारिश मेरी यही है कि अगर ये हफ्ते में दो बार होता या तीन बार होता तो इसे हमारी प्रोनाउंसिएशन भी ठीक हो जाती और हम भी खुश होते सर.
जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. वंडरफुल वंडरफुल सर. हमें जान के बहुत खुशी हुई कि एक शोक जोक आप में बेदार हुआ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज को पढ़ने का, उसको शौक से पढ़ने का. थैंक्स अ लॉट इतना कीनली हमारा प्रोग्राम वॉच करने के लिए सर. और हमारा मकसद भी यही होता है कि हम इतना अच्छा प्रोग्राम यहाँ पे जो है डिलीवर करें, इतना अच्छा लेक्चर यहाँ पे डिलीवर हो कि आप में शोक जोक पैदा हो सब्जेक्ट को और कीनली स्टडी करने के लिए. थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर योर कॉलिंग एंड रिगार्डिंग योर सजेशन की दो या तीन बार एक हफ्ते में होना चाहिए, उसके बारे में डेफिनेटली हम बात करेंगे. जी और इस प्रोग्राम को आप रिपीट भी देख सकते हैं. हर ट्यूसडे शाम हम रिपीट होते हैं, ये प्रोग्राम हम रिपीट करते हैं शाम 7:30 से लेकर 8:30. एंड देन थर्सडेज एवरी मॉर्निंग वी कम ऑन एयर फ्रॉम 9:10 AM टू 10:10 AM. एंड बिसाइड्स वी आर आल्सो रिसीविंग सो मेनी ईमेल्स, बट बिफोर वी कम टू ईमेल्स वी हैव मोरिफत साहब जुड़ चुके हैं हमारे साथ बड़गाम से. अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर. मोरिफत साहब खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में.
हेलो सर. हेलो जमशेद सर. अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम.
Sir, actually, a lot of thanks to your DDK team that each and every Sunday you are bringing a new expert with you. And today we have got an English expert.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. Today I have a question related with the topic.
Right.
What is the essence of classifying English alphabets as vowels and consonants? What is their essence?
Yes, we got your question. We got your question. Do we have any other question?
Sir, actually, I have another question. I want the pronunciation of word CIRCUMUMBULATION.
काफी trivial सा pronunciation रहेगा इसका. एक बार फिर से आप repeat कर दें.
CIRCUMUMBULATION.
हाँ TOM right last में.
Yes, TIOM.
TIOM. जी जी जी.
My word and I want the pronunciation.
जी चलिए ठीक है, थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर योर कॉल. आपने क्वेश्चंस पूछे, आपने क्वेश्चंस के जवाब लीजिए.
या व्हेन इट कम्स टू द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ वोवेल्स एंड कॉन्सोनेंट्स, वार साहब हैज ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट इट इन डिटेल एंड ही हैज गिवन सफिशिएंट एग्जांपल्स आल्सो ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ यू नो वर्ड्स एंड डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ साउंड्स. ब्रॉडली स्पीकिंग व्हेन इट कम्स टू वोवेल साउंड्स, वी डिवाइड देम इनटू मोनोफथोंग्स एंड डिफथोंग्स, बट बोथ आर वोवेल्स, बोथ ऑफ देम रिमेन एक्चुअली प्योर वोवेल्स. एंड देन अमंग कॉन्सोनेंट साउंड्स, कॉन्सोनेंट्स आर ऑल्सो डिवाइडेड, देर आर इन टोटल 24 कॉन्सोनेंट्स, एंड दोज कॉन्सोनेंट्स आर ऑल्सो डिवाइडेड इनटू डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ कैटेगरीज. वी हैव लाइक प्लोसिवस आर देयर, फ्रिकेटिवस आर देयर, affricates are there, nasals are there, so there are different kinds of, so this is the classification of it.
जी थैंक्स अ लॉट इस खूबसूरत से जवाब के लिए. और इससे पहले कि हम लतीफ अहमद से बात करें, मैं ये बताना चाहूंगा कि नजीर अहमद ने हमें कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट किया है इस प्रोग्राम के थ्रू द मीडियम ऑफ ईमेल. एंड बिसाइड्स दैट, शाहिद नजीर साहब जो है यूट्यूब पे लास्ट वाला प्रोग्राम देखना चाहते हैं और कहते हैं कि इतना ताखीर क्यों होती है यूट्यूब पे अपलोड करने में. कभी कभी हो जाता है, लेकिन यूजुअली हम ट्राई करते हैं कि एक हफ्ते के अंदर ही यूट्यूब पे वो जो है अपलोड हो जाए. जी बिल्कुल, आपकी सजेशन अब तक पहुंच चुकी है, डेफिनेटली अपलोड हो जाएगा लास्ट वाला प्रोग्राम भी. एंड लतीफ अहमद साहब, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, खैर मकदम आपका आज के प्रोग्राम में.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम.
सर मेरा सवाल यह है, जो ईटीसी लिखते हैं ना हम एटसेट्रा की जगह,
एक बार फिर से पूछ लीजिए.
ईटीसी लिखते हैं ना हम एटसेट्रा की जगह.
जी जी जी.
हाँ सर, इसका साउंड मिलता है जैसे हम आई लिखते हैं, दैट इज, वो कैसे मिलता है आई या ई जी फॉर एग्जाम्पल.
जी 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 जी, ये पूछना चाहता, थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. ये पूछना चाहता, फॉर एग्जांपल जब शॉर्ट फॉर्म लिखते हैं ईटीसी, हाउ डू वी प्रोनाउंस इट, या कहीं पे हम लिखते हैं कि एसएप एज सून एज पॉसिबल, सो हाउ डू वी गेज व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल प्रोनाउंसिएशन व्हेन वी राइट इट इन सच अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म.
नो सी, बेसिकली द प्रोफाउंड ट्रूथ अबाउट ऑल ऑफ अस इज दैट वी आर पुअर कंसल्टर्स ऑफ डिक्शनरी, वी डोंट कंसल्ट डिक्शनरीज. If you consult even, I mean, for this particular issue also, etc., or for that matter, there is another IE, IDEST. IE stands for IDEST. In the same way, for example, EG, it is exemplary gratia.
Exemplary?
It is exemplary gratia. And in the same way, we have, you know, this particular question which he asked. We'll find the meaning, the broader meaning of all these, the elaborate pronunciation, transcription of these in dictionaries. But unfortunately, we don't consult dictionaries.
And sometimes we tend to overlook these words. For ETC, hai, chali, ye toh bachpan se padhte aa raha hai, ab kya ispe deep down research karne ki zarurat hai.
Absolutely.
But I think the need of the hour is that we need to consult dictionaries.
We need to consult, and unfortunately, there we are not good at consulting.
And jitna wakat hum social networking sites
absolutely.
Pe guzarte hai, uska ek dihai.
The minimum,
एक दसवां वक्त अगर हम डिक्शनरी कंसल्ट करने में लगे तो हमारी प्रोनंसिएशन भी बेटर हो जाएगी.
With due respect to what you said, the minimum that we can do is that we can upload an app.
Right.
On our mobile phones. Uh-huh. All of us use mobile gadgets now. And smart mobile phones. We can upload some mobile dictionary. Which helps us
कुछ
to
तीन चार के अगर आप नाम बताना चाहें जो
I mean there are plenty of them. Just I mean in your Play Store you just log I mean log type I mean mobile app dictionary and it will be downloaded.
Dictionary की हम बात करते हैं, एक वो thesaurus का भी एक app आता है वहाँ पे.
Absolutely.
क्या उसका क्या usage है?
Thesaurus actually you know gives you elaborate explanations about antonyms and synonyms.
जी.
Thesaurus does not necessarily give you about knowledge about pronunciation. And you know here I would like to sound a note of caution also. This is important that when our students purchase a dictionary, they must make it a point that they purchase a dictionary which first of all gives them pronunciation.
Right.
I mean phonetic symbols. Warsaw talked about phonetic symbols. There are many dictionaries which are available in the market but which do not give us phonetic symbols. So this is the first prerequisite. Then second is that the dictionary should also give us the meaning of the word.
Right.
Third is usage.
जी.
Likewise, antonyms and synonyms. The fifth is word brand, whether the word is used as a noun, verb or an adjective.
बिल्कुल, यहाँ पे कथा कलामी के लिए आपसे माफी चाहूंगा. रूप साहब जुड़ चुके हैं डांगरपुरा से. अस्सलाम वालेकुम रूप साहब, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में. रूप साहब खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में, अपना सवाल पूछिए.
हेलो.
जी सर खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में, अपना सवाल पूछिए सर.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम.
जी हमारा एक we have just a simple question कि हम जो ये इंग्लिश में बात कर रहे हैं तो हमारे पास इस वक्त जो तीन स्टैंडर्ड्स हो रहे हैं कि हम इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड भी यूज कर रहे हैं.
जी.
तो मैं ये इतना सिंपल सा क्वेश्चन है कि जो ये हम इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड जो इस वक्त कर रहे हैं हम अपने मीन्स इंग्लिश में.
जी.
तो इसका बेसिक वजूद कहाँ से आया? इफ इट इज बेसिकली ब्रिटिश लैंग्वेज,
बिल्कुल,
व्हाई देयर हैज कम एंटर्ड दीस काइंड्स ऑफ इंडियन साउंड्स देयर.
Yes, I think आपका क्वेश्चन अब तक पहुंच चुका है, लेकिन इसी से रेलिवेंट एसोसिएटेड मेरा भी एक क्वेश्चन ये है कि सर जहां तक L1 की हम बात करते हैं, वो जबान जो हम बचपन से सीखते हैं, राइट फ्रॉम द बैबलिंग स्टेज, उसके बाद फॉर्मेटिव ईयर्स में, उसमें हमें एक लिंग्विस्टिक कॉम्पिटेंस आ जाता है कि हम माहिर हो जाते हैं उस जबान के
जी.
अब एक फॉरन लैंग्वेज हम सीखते हैं, वो हमने बैबलिंग लैंग्वेज टाइम पे नहीं सीखी, फॉर्मेटिव ईयर्स में नहीं सीखी, ऑल फर्स्ट सडन 17 साल की एज पे हम वो सीखना स्टार्ट करते हैं, तो उसमें कितनी कॉम्पिटेंस हमारी जो उसमें आ जाती है. अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम, जैसे कि ये भी पूछ रहे थे कि इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड कहां से आ गया, जैसे हम ऑक्सफोर्ड डिक्शनरी में एक वर्ड देखते हैं चटनीफाइंग, ही चटनीफाइड द होल थिंग, मसाला डाल के, तो ये कब से ऑक्सफोर्ड डिक्शनरी में ऐसे वर्ड्स आने लगे और इंडियन वर्ड्स कहां से आ गए, जैसे हम देखते हैं कि पंडित वर्ड एक यूज होता है ऑक्सफोर्ड डिक्शनरी में, तो ये कब से स्टार्ट हुआ.
दैट्स राइट, दैट्स राइट. See, I'll answer his question first and then your question. These are two different questions. One is about Indian standard and British standard.
Ji.
We all know that it is in 16th century itself.
Ji.
16th, when Queen Elizabeth actually signed a charter act with the then Mughal rulers.
Ji.
And this way actually East India Company came to India.
Mm-hmm.
And with the passage of time, you know, they developed an interest in developing in English education system in India.
Right.
And this way you see in English language arrived in India.
Ji.
And with the passage of time you see that actually English language went through different stages. First of all it came in contact with it. Ji. And then it consolidated its roots.
Ji.
And today we see that there is a stark difference between Indian English and British English.
And I don't mind if you shelve my question for the time being because we have MK Bhatt Saab on the line.
Mm-hmm.
Assalamu alaikum sir, khair makdam aapka program mein. गुड आफ्टरनून भट्ट साहब, खैर मकदम आपका प्रोग्राम में.
गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबॉडी, स्पेशली आई कंग्रेचुलेट द कंसर्न्ड प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम एंड स्पेशली द दूरदर्शन केंद्र डायरेक्टर दैट ही हैज चोजन दिस सब्जेक्ट ऑफ फोनेटिक व्हिच इज वेरी मच लैगिंग इन जेएन के स्टूडेंट्स एंड स्पेशली ऑफ द टीचर्स.
जी,
द टीचर गिवन दिस लेक्चर अबाउट फोनेटिक, दिस इज माय टेट सब्जेक्ट इन फेब्रुअरी सर, बिकॉज आई एम टीचिंग इन माय कॉलेज टू स्टूडेंट्स व्हिच इज वेरी वेरी मच लैगिंग. I can tell straightforward. I have gone to University of Kashmir. My head of department was Mr. Jayaramanthan. But I want to speak about this. The teacher concerned has given good lecture, but some of the errors and omissions in this. But first of all, I want to tell the concerned teacher, you should always use, while giving the lecture in the concern, use the arms, the lips, phonetics, the air, the lips, right? And chover panam chover, you say chover shubnan chover put katakan, just everybody. You move your lips on the right side. Bah, yeah, ho, wherein, class, act with your arms and everything the legs were the English. English speakers, that is not a childish way to speak English. It is very tough English. And the students should be mesmerized by this phonetic language. I want to speak to the concerned teacher, what is the word? I'll begin the word to the expert. And yes, and U A N C E S, and U A N C E.
I think, sir, we have got the gist of your question. And first of all, it's good afternoon because it's 10 minutes past 12. I think, sir, we have got the gist of your question. Expert sir is here because we have very limited time on this very program. So thanks a lot for calling in. And before you answer him, Ghulam Mohideen Sophie is with us. He's joined us from Bangalore, all the way from Bangalore. Sir, a very warm good afternoon to you.
MK Bhatt.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. So please keep the volume of your television set. It has to be inaudibly low. Please keep it such. Yes.
मैं गुलाम सिंह सोफी बेंगलोर से बोल रहा हूँ.
जी सर, अपना सवाल पूछिए.
तो मुझे हम लोग रोजाना ये आपका प्रोग्राम हर हफ्ते बहुत ही अच्छा प्रोग्राम.
जी.
और खासकर इंग्लिश के जितने भी आज तक लेक्चर हुए
जी
बहुत ही अच्छे रहे.
जी.
और मेरे बच्चे, मैं अपने बच्चों के साथ बैठ करके इनको इसी से सिखाता हूँ, ये चाहे प्रोनाउंसिएशन हो चाहे कंट्रैक्शन हो.
जी.
बहुत ही अच्छा लगा. और जो वार्ता का जो लेक्चर है, ये वन ऑफ द बेस्ट लेक्चर इस सीरीज के रहे.
थैंक यू सर, थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर कॉम्प्लीमेंटिंग अवर प्रोग्राम. डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन सर?
तो बेसिकली मेरा ये क्वेश्चन है कि हम कश्मीर के पुराने कश्मीरी लोग थे, उन्होंने इंग्लिश के बहुत सारे वर्ड जैसे ब्रिटेन कहते थे या शॉल को टोल कहते हैं, इस तरह से जो इंडियन
आइज
राइट और इन कश्मीरी.
जी, I think we have got the gist of your question. Thanks a lot for complimenting. But try to him. MK Bhatt called us.
Yes, yes, yes.
If you can briefly just comment on
yes, yes, yes. My straightforward suggestion to MK Bhatt would be for future programs also.
जी.
Whenever he makes a call, he must make it a point that his questions are very precise and very, you know, pointed.
जी.
Unfortunately, I mean, he comes up with elaborate explanations and जी. Then it becomes very difficult to for even experts and the teachers also, whether he is asking a question or making a comment. So if he has a straightforward question, he should come up with a, he should first of all pen it down
जी,
and
जी.
Straight way ask a question within just stipulated time of 30 seconds.
बिल्कुल इस खूबसूरत से जवाब के लिए थोड़ा आई वुड से इट वाज अ लिटिल टर्स रिप्लाई बट आई थिंक इट वाज अ नीड ऑफ द आवर एनीवे. थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर कॉलिंग इन एंड सोफी साहब ने भी बैंगलोर से कॉल किया उनका भी बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. उसके अलावा एक और ईमेल जो मैं डेफिनेटली पढ़ना चाहूंगा प्रोफेसर फयाज अहमद प्रिंसिपल गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज टंगमर्ग से लिखते हैं कि आई ऑफर माई सर्विसेज इन कॉमर्स 11th एंड 12th. सर थैंक्स अ लॉट, वी डोंट नीड योर सर्विस, वी नीड योर कोलैबोरेशन. रिपीट टाइमिंग ऑफ द प्रोग्राम.
Yes, you can, viewers, you can watch the repeat telecast of our program on Tuesday at sharp 7:30 PM and on Thursday in the morning at 9:10 AM.
जी बिल्कुल, और इसी दुआ के साथ कि आप जो भी करें अल्लाह आपको कामयाबी और कामरानी से हमकिनार करे. दीजिए अपने मेजबान जमशेद रसूल और हया को आज के प्रोग्राम से इजाजत. अल्लाह हाफिज़ व नासिर.